In the last two videos, we have learned that how to use Hadamard gate on a single qubit and how to extend Hadamard gate to use on multiple qubits. In this video, we will learn that from where such equations come. Basically, when we're dealing with Hadamard gates and we want to apply Hadamard gate on any n qubit, we just write either this equation or this equation directly. And some of the students are not able to understand that what happened, from where these equations come. So in this video, I will try to basically derive these equations. So let's start. So let's start from this part of the board first. So we know that when we apply Hadamard gate on ket 0, then my answer is ket 0 plus ket 1 divided by square root of 2. In contrast, if I apply Hadamard gate on ket 1, then my answer is ket 0 minus ket 1 divided by square root. In the first step, I have to combine these two formulas in one formula. I can combine them by saying that Hadamard gate being applied on x, where x could be either 0 or 1. Is ket 0, because ket 0 is common in both of those formulas, so I can write ket 0 as it is, and then it could be like either plus sign or could be minus sign, so I write here minus 1 raised to power x. I will explain why minus 1 raised to power x works, and then I will have ket 1, and this whole thing is divided by square root of 2. Now, ket 1 raised to power x works because we know that the sign is minus in case of 1 and sign is plus in case of ket 0. So when we say minus 1 raised to power 0, then it becomes 1, so the sign remains plus. When we say minus 1 raised to power 1, then in that case, answer is minus 1, so the sign changed to minus from plus. So that's why this formula works in both of those cases. But now we have to make this formula even more general by using summation sign. So we say that Hadamard gate being applied on ket x, where x could be either 0 and 1, is equals to summation. And for summation, we have to introduce a new variable because that variable should take value of 0 and 1. X could be either 0 and 1, but the variable should take both values, first 0 and then 1. And there are different ways to write summation. One way is that you can say new variable y, and y could take value from 0 to 1. And this way of writing summation also works, but mostly people don't use that in quantum computing. Mostly people use this way of writing summation, that they say that a new variable y, and y belongs to 0 and 1. Then here we will have ket y, because first y will take value 0, then y will take value 1, and obviously we have to also write 1 over square root 2. We can write 1 over square root 2 here maybe. Now the only thing left is the sign. Here sign is always positive, with 0, ket 0, but with ket 1, sign will be a minus, a sign could be plus. So we write here minus 1 raised to power x dot y. It is because sign is minus 1 when we have this x here, 1, and this y here, 1, then sign should be minus 1. So that's why we say x and y. So the sign will be minus 1 only when x and y both are 1, otherwise sign will be always plus. Now we're getting closer because this formula here is starting to look more and more like this formula. We are not there yet, but this formula is almost like this formula. So let's say I say this my equation 1, and now I continue. I have now a general formula that works when x is single qubit. Now I have to write formula for two qubits. We say we apply Hadamard gate tensor product 2 on cat x, where x is a 2-qubit register. So we say that x belongs to 0, 1 raised to power 2, which is equivalent to saying that x belongs to the set 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Or we can also say that x belongs to the set 0, 1, 2, 3. So these three notations are the same, but usually this one is used in quantum computing. So we will stick with this one for the time being. Because it is 2-qubit, so you can write it like Hadamard gate being applied on x1, where x1 is the first qubit of the register, where x1 can take values from 0 and 1. Tensor product with Hadamard gate being applied on x2, where x2 is once again a single qubit register. So these two are single qubit register. Now we expand this equation by putting equation number 1 here and here. So now we will have here equation number 1 and tensor product with once again equation number 1. So we write here 1 over square root of 2, and now we have to introduce a new variable y1, where y1 belongs to 0, 1 and minus 1, and because I have here x1 and I have here y1, so I say minus 1 raised to power x1 y1, and similarly I have here cat y1. This is my first equation. Second equation is going to be 1 over square root of 2 summation y2 belongs to 0 and 1. Y2 is my another variable, and minus 1. Now I will write here x2, because this is x2 dot y2, and now I will say here cat y2. So now we have to combine both of those equations. So what we have here is 1 over square root of 2 raised to power 2, because we have 2 times 1 over square root 2, 1 over square root 2. So we have 1 over square root 2 raised to power 2. I could have written 1 over 2, but I'm writing it intentionally as 1 over square root 2 raised to power 2, because from here we're going to get this equation eventually. And then I will have here summation. When we combine both of those summations, we have a new variable y. Y will take value from 0, 1 raised to power 2. So you can think of both of those summations as for loop in computer science, and they were nested for loops. So when we combine them, we will have a loop that runs twice as many times. So y once again can take value from 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Then we will have here minus 1, because they are multiplying each other, these two numbers, so their power will add. We will have here x1, y1 plus x2, y2. And then because we have a new variable y, so we will have here cat y. So this is our new equation. And now we define x1 times y1 plus x2 times y2 as x dot y. So from here we get to this equation. This equation is also for the n-qubit, but this equation is just a general form of this equation. Here we have used 2-qubits, so we have say 2 raised to power 2. Here we have n-qubits, 2 raised to power n. So otherwise this equation is same as this equation. Here we have y belongs to 0, 1 raised to power 2. Here we have y belongs to 0, 1 raised to power n. But in quantum computing, many times, we only need to write this equation. Because in quantum computing, many times, we start with a register with all 0 qubits, and then we apply Hadamard gate on that qubits. When the register have all 0 qubits, then we don't have to worry about the sign, because the sign of all the terms going to be positive. So that's why this one is simplified version of this one. In this case, we don't have to worry about minus one sign here. I have here used different notation, that y from 1 to n minus 1, but this is same as saying y belongs to 0, 1 raised to power n. So I hope that now you'll be able to understand these equations and can expand these equations. And whenever we are developing a quantum algorithm and we apply Hadamard gate on some qubits and we just quickly write this equation, then you will not be confused and you know what's going on. That's it for this video. See you next time. Stay tuned.